Hello, everybody. It's your boy, Mr. G, coming at you live. And we have a video for multiplying polynomials. So here we go. Let's get it. Now, multiplying polynomials, I'm going to multiply a monomial by a polynomial first. Let's keep it simple. So really what this actually looks like is negative 4x to the third power times x squared plus 3x minus 4. So this is how we're going to see them written a lot of when we have products here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to treat this the same thing as if this was 4 times x plus 3. We're going to use the distributive property. So if I was doing this problem, I would just do 4 times x, 4 times 3. I'm multiplying the outside by everything on the inside. Same principle applies here. So I'm going to multiply my negative 4x to the third by every single thing inside my parentheses, because this is negative 4x to the third times all of this. But I need to follow my multiplication rules and my exponent rules when I do this. So here's what I mean by that. I have negative 4x to the third, and I'm multiplying that with x squared. Okay. I am now also going to multiply negative, and you know what, and I can add this or subtract, it doesn't really matter how we look at it. I'll say I'm also multiplying this with negative 4x to the third times 3x, and I'm also multiplying this with 4x to the third times negative 4. So now when I do my multiplication, I'm going to multiply the coefficients. So negative 4 times 1, well, that's negative 4, but now I got to do x third times x squared. So x third times x squared is when we just add the exponents, and that's x to the fifth, and that's just following our product of powers property. If I were to multiply these two numbers, we know this is just 3 plus 2, because this is 3x's, 2x's, which gives me a total of 5x's being multiplied. Same thing here. So now, negative 4 times 3 is negative 12. X to the third times x is x to the fourth. Negative 4 times negative 4 is positive 16. X to the third times, I don't have to multiply it by anything, so my x to the third just stays. I'm done. There's nothing else I need to do here. I have my simplified answer. I cannot combine any of these because I have fifths, fourths, and thirds. They are different powers, so therefore they cannot be combined, and I'm done. Go ahead and try this one real quick on your own, and then check back to see how you do. All right, so distributive property, same situation. So I have negative 2x squared times x squared. I have negative 2x squared times 3x, and then I have negative 2x squared times 4. Those are the three math problems I'm doing. So this is going to become negative 2x to the fourth. This will become negative 6x to the third, because x squared times x is x to the third, because this is like having x to the first. Negative 2 times 3 is negative 6. And then this is going to become negative 2 times 4 is negative 8, and then the x squared just stays. I'm done. Now, one thing I want to look at is we're going to multiply multiple binomials now. So instead of having a single monomial multiplied by a polynomial, I'm going to multiply multiple terms inside my parentheses, so a binomial by another binomial. So we're going to compare it with 15 times 18 real quick, just to kind of show how this works. So when we multiply 15 times 18, really what we do is we do 8 times 5, but then we do 8 times 10. So really, we can read, and then we do 1 times 5, I mean, this 1 is really 10, so then we do 10 times 5, and then 10 times 10 is what we're doing when we're multiplying like this. So really, 15, when we're multiplying, it's really just 10 plus 5. We have the 10, and then we have 5, and then 18 is really 10 plus 8. So I can really write down 15 as 10 plus 5 times 10 plus 8 is essentially what we're doing here. Because again, 8 times 5, and then I do 8 times 10. I then do 10 times 5, and then 10 times 10. So we're going to use the same principle here as we do here. So here I set up a table just to show I have 10 plus 8 here. I have 10 plus 5. And this shows my four things that I'm really multiplying here. I'm doing 10 times 10, which is 100. I'm doing 10 times 8, which is 80. I'm doing 5 times 10, which is 50. And then 5 times 8, which is 40. If I add all of these up, I'm going to get 270, which is really what 15 times 18 is, okay? Because 100, this is 180, 180 plus 90 is 270. We're going to do the same thing here. So what I did is I broke down x plus 5. So here's x plus 5. Here's x plus 8. And now I'm going to multiply all four values here. So this box represents x times x. Well, x times x is x squared. Now I have x times 8. That's 8x. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times 8 is 40. Now I'm going to add all these together. Well, when I add all these together, I have x squared plus 5x plus 8x plus 40. Well, I can't combine x squared with anything because I have no other squares to combine it with. I can combine these two guys, though, to make this 13x, and then I have my 40. I'm done. There's nothing else I have to do. I can't simplify it anymore. So when I do x plus 5 times x plus 8, I'm multiplying all these pieces together. Now, another way to get there is just to do distributive property again. But when I say do distributive property again, we're distributing twice now. Because what I have to do is this is x plus 5 times all of x plus 8. Well, I have to multiply both these terms by everything on this side. So I'm doing my distributive property of my x. This is just x times x and x times 8. I'm also doing the 5 times x and the 5 times 8 as well. Very similar to what we did here. We did 10 times 10, and we did 10 times 8. 10 times 10, 10 times 8. I also did 5 times 10 and 5 times 8. 5 times 10 and 5 times 8. Same thing. X times x is x squared. X times 8 is 8x. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times 8 is 40. And then I add them all up, or I combine them all. So let's look at another one to show how I would do it with distributive property without actually making a table. So 2x plus 4 equals, 2x plus 4 times x minus 5. So I'm going to do my distributive property, 2x times x, and then I'm also going to do 2x times negative 5. I'm just distributing this 2x to everything on the right side. So 2x times x is 2x squared. 2x, because I'm 2 times 1 is 2, x times x is x squared. 2x times negative 5, well, 2 times negative 5 is negative 10, and then my x just kind of hangs out, just stays. Now I have to do the exact same thing, but I have to do it with the 4. I have to distribute the 4, multiply 4 times x, and I have to multiply 4 times 5. Well, 4 times x is 4x. 4 times negative 5 is negative 20. Now I can combine my like terms here. I still have 2x squared minus 6x minus 20. I'm done. I'm left with a quadratic trinomial. Okay. Try this one on your own. See how you do. We're just doing distributive property, but now we're doing it twice. Okay, so it should be 5x times 2x, 5x times 1. So 5x times 2x, well, 5 times 2 is 10. X times x is x squared. That's a 10, not a 6. There you go. 5 times 1, 5x times 1, well, 5 times 1 is 5, and then bring the x. Now I have to do 4 times 2x. I can go underneath to show different lines here. So negative 4 times 2x is negative 8x. Negative 4 times positive 1 is negative 4. Now I can combine my like terms. That makes negative 3x. Bring down my minus 4. Bring out my 10x squared. I'm done. Okay. Try this one if you would like. And actually, I'm going to move on just for the sake of time, make this video a little bit shorter. So I have x squared plus 2x minus 1 and 3x plus 4. So now I have a trinomial by a binomial. We could do the distributive property. The rules really still apply, but we could also make it as a table if we needed to as well. So again, I have a table here. Let me finish my table. There we go. And I set up my trinomial on top, my binomial on the side, and this shows me all the things I'm multiplying. I'm doing 3x times x squared here, which is 3x to the third power. 3x times 2x is 6x squared. 3x times negative 1 is negative 3x. Here I have 4x squared, 8x, and negative 4. And then I'm looking at combining all of these, because it's really 6x squared minus 3x plus 4x squared plus 8x minus 4. Can combine my like terms, that makes 10x squared, and then I'm gonna do squiggles, so these are like terms, and then that makes 5x minus 4, and then bring down my 3x to the third. There's my final answer. So I could make a table each and every single time. Just set up your trinomial, set up your binomial, make a table of boxes, and just multiply for each box. Or I could have still done distributive property and multiply everything in here by everything in there as well. It does not matter how you choose to do it. So like, let's look at this one right here. If you want to try it on your own, please, okay? And then I'm going to show you how I would do this one. So the way I would do this is I would always set up my binomial in front of my trinomial. Set up the least amount of terms first, because I know I'm going to do distributive property. I just have to multiply this 5y by everything on my second term. So it's going to be like so. So 5y times 4. Y squared. That's 20y to the third, because 5 times 4 is 20, y times y squared is y to the third. 5y times 3y is 15y squared. 5y times negative 1 is negative 5y. Now I'm going to do the same thing, but with the negative 2. So I'm going to distribute this negative 2 to all three pieces. Negative 2 times 4y squared, negative 8y squared, negative 2 times 3y, negative 6y, negative 2 times negative 1, positive 2. And then now I can combine my like terms. Those are two like terms. 15y squared, negative 8y squared is 7y squared. And then negative 5y, negative 6y is negative 11y. Notice how I'm still writing, bring down my last two values that I didn't use. But notice I'm still writing in standard form. I have my power to the 3 first. Oh, I didn't use my sign there. Plus 7y squared minus 11y plus 2. I'm done. So guys, we're just doing distributive property, but we're doing like a crazy distributive property where it's happening multiple times, okay? So that's it. That's all I got for you. If you guys have any questions, please let me know. Oh, there's a joke necessary. Sorry. Where is the best place to do your math homework? Where is the best place to do your math homework? You should do it on a multiplication table. Boom! All right. With that said, if you guys have any questions, let me know. Gradius out.